Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And many of you had requested for a video using Astakwaka on foreign travel and traveling abroad for educational or career purposes. So here it is. Today we'll try to see if somebody will go abroad, or before seeing if somebody goes, we will try to see, is there any use of going abroad by this person, or the person will suffer once they go abroad? And when I say abroad, it doesn't mean from India to US or Germany. It can mean three things. Primarily, abroad means a place where the food is different, totally different, the speech is totally different, and the clothing, the culture. So if these three things are totally different, well, you may go from for example Jammu and Kashmir to Uttar Pradesh, and if you feel that this difference is there, maybe you are in a foreign land. But maybe if you go from Amritsar to Rawalpindi, which is in Pakistan, and Amritsar is in India, so you may not feel that you have gone abroad, because the places will be very similar. So before you make a blank judgment of what is abroad or what is not, depending on current geopolitics, so please take care in mind to analyze these three criterias. And now let us discuss with an example chart. I have used this chart for Astakwaka, if I remember, before. And now let us again analyze what is going on, right? And as usual, if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a specialized Astakwaka reading from me regarding your chart, you can go to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Alright, so this is Scorpio Ascendant. So this number 8 is the Ascendant. Alright, this is not the Ascendant 1, it's the 8. So here you go. First of all, as usual, you have to check what's going on in the Ascendant. So if you go to the Ascendant, what's happening? There are 30 points, and you see Sun is giving 3 points, then Moon 4, decent contributions, then Mars has very high contribution there. Point to be noted. Then Mercury also has quite contribution, Jupiter as usual. Venus also, again another point to be noted. Then what about Saturn? Saturn barely has any contribution. Now see, whenever you talk of abroad specifically, then you must check the 12th Lord. Alright, how much 12th Lord is interested in the Ascendant, or how much is the Ascendant interested in the 12th house? So now if you go by traditional, some wrong or some fake Astakwaka calculation, if you see the 12th house, you will see there are 18 points. So according to the traditional, I won't call it traditional, it's like a fake system of 28 points. This is terrible. So somebody will see this and say, oh my God, if you go to the foreign lands, you will have suffering, your life will be hellish, okay, blah blah blah, all the nonsense. Because she has 18, which is like terrible, because which is like 10 less than 28. Alright, so there's nothing like that, that below 28 is less or above 28 is good. It's not like that. You have to see who are those people who are contributing there. Alright, so now you see in the Ascendant, which is Scorpio, you see Venus is the 12th Lord, because Libra is in the 12th house, lorded by Venus, is contributing highest, 6 points, apart from Mars. Alright, and Mars is the Lagna Lord and the 6th Lord. So this can show the person wants to go and do job abroad. Alright, now Venus is also the 7th Lord. Alright, so then it can show that the person is either happy in doing job or business, because 7th house can show business. But see, Mars is also the Ascendant Lord. So this means the person has to be very much concerned with what he or she likes during the job or business. So it has to be on her terms. Alright, so that is why this is very important. the person can't do things which she doesn't like, because Mars is the Lagnesh. Lagnesh is the self. So in the Lagna, the Lagnesh is contributing quite a bit, which means she is very much concerned about what she thinks is right, wrong, good, bad, proper, not proper, so and so. And here the 12th lord is contributing, and Mool Trikon sign of Venus is Libra, which is the 12th house. So 12th lord is contributing to the Lagna means the person is very, the person can be interested in going abroad. That's very important. And now, whenever a person is asking about going abroad, you have to ask him, why do you want to go abroad? Is it for education or is it for career? I mean, do you want to go get your master's or bachelor's or PhD and come back? Or you want to work there and permanently settle there? Alright, so these are two different areas. Or work for a short time and come back. I could segregate into three parts. So some people say we will do our masters and come back. Some say we will do masters and do job for 5 years and come back. And some say no, we will do masters and job and permanently settle there. So let us check for education. So let us go and check for education which houses are there. See, we have the fourth house, which is the prime house of education. What about the fourth house and fourth lord? So fourth house is having 31 points, which is Aquarius. So in Aquarius, the points are quite balanced, decent level. Venus also contributes equally and Saturn also contributes equally. Now Saturn is the fourth lord, and because Saturn has less points in Ashtak Varga, so if it contributes equally than any other planet, it still has higher weightage. So Venus as the 12th lord has 4 points, but Saturn has 4. So Saturn will have more weight. So this can show that the primary education of the person can be in the homeland or hometown. Alright. Well, then what about the 5th house? Well, we have Pisces here. So let's go to Pisces. What's going on? Pisces, you see, Venus has more contribution than Saturn. Okay, so that means she could travel abroad or to a distant land for her bachelor's. Alright. And if you check carefully, Moon, which is the 9th lord, which again shows long distance travel, has quite some contribution there. And Jupiter has the highest contribution. Jupiter is the lord of the 2nd and the 5th. So now 2nd house contributing to the 5th house. This means the family will be still very important. So how do you reconcile with the fact that the person has to travel abroad for education, for bachelor's, but the family is very important? So how, if I told you the mother of this girl also shifted with her when she changed the city? Her mother changed the city and she also went and started staying with her. Alright, because there you see the 2nd house is involved, the family is involved. Then let's go to the 9th house. 9th house has the sign Cancer. So we go to number 4. There, my God, Venus has 7 points. He is the king there. No disputes. So therefore, for masters, she will definitely want to go abroad. There is no compromise on this fact at any cost. And what about Mercury? Mercury is the lord of the 11th house. He is contributing 4 points. That's still great. What about Sun? Sun is contributing 4 points to the 9th house here. Okay. And Mercury, as I said, 5 points to the 9th house. That's still good. Now let us go to the 12th house. If you go to the 12th house, you will see again Venus has 4 points there. Again. Libra. And Sun, who is the 10th lord, has 4 points, which is fantastic. So 10th lord is interested in foreign land. That means the moment she goes abroad, she will get name and fame. So the conclusion is that her basic education could be in her homeland, in her home city or her birthplace. Then during her bachelor's, as I said, the 2nd lord is involved. So her mother went and stayed with her, and now during her master's, she might go abroad. And will she do great as career wise in the foreign lands? Well, very good, I think, because in the 12th house, Sun, who is the 10th lord, has very high contribution, and Mercury also has quite contribution there. And Venus also has the 12th lord is contributing there, all right? Now, Mercury is also, now that's the predicament. See here, Mercury is the 11th lord and is also the 8th lord. It's a lot of a Dusthana here, all right? So, in any area, wherever Mercury contributes, some ups and downs will be there, and only after that there will be success, foreign or homeland or marriage or whatever it is. Because Mercury has the responsibility of both the houses, you see. But he is the primarily the 11th lord, because the Mool Trikon sign is in the 11th house, Virgo. So he is primarily going to give results of the 11th house. Now let us check the 11th house, or let's check the 10th house of career first, alright. So 10th house is 29 points. Let us go to Leo. What's going on here? Saturn has huge contribution. Saturn, Mercury, 11th lord, Mercury contributing to 10th house is fantastic. Sun has the 10th lord contributing is fantastic. And now Saturn has huge contribution. And Saturn is 3rd lord, 4th lord. So her primary education could happen in, like, if suppose it happened in physics or chemistry or science, then maybe those things are very important in her profession, okay? Maybe she is in a profession where she has to use the knowledge of her primary school. Or she might have to travel or write a lot of stuff. That could be there here in the 10th house, because Saturn is the 3rd lord. And apart from that, if you see, Sun itself is contributing to the 10th house. Now let's go to the 11th house. 11th house, again you see this Jupiter has quite contribution. Alright, so if you see in the 10th and the 11th houses, Venus doesn't have much contribution. Okay, so this definitely means that if she asks me a question, should I go and settle abroad permanently for my career purposes, or should I stay in India? Well, I could say that, well, you can also stay in India. You don't have to settle abroad for your career reasons. You don't seem to make millions or billions there if you stay there. Alright. Or you don't seem to have a lot of fulfillment in career or anything like that. But will you succeed if you go? Yes, definitely, because in Libra, Sun has quite contribution. You know, the 10th lord is contributing. So this is like a chart who can go to abroad for masters and for PhD or these kind of things, and can work for some years, and then it's recommended she comes back to India and she will have great success here. Alright, so this is not a chart where I would suggest permanent settlement abroad. This is not a chart. Alright. If she asks me only for career reasons. But nobody will only ask you now for career. They will ask you for marriage, for childbirth, for all the things. Then you have to analyze and see, you know, how one decision in a particular area of life could affect the other areas. Okay. So therefore, you have to analyze the whole chart, and only then you have to give some predictions or make a judgment. Alright, so she can go abroad, work for some years and come back, and depending on her dasha, it will be decided what she should do, and the dasha lords, how much they are contributing Ashtak Varga. Alright, so if you have not watched my video on Vimshottari dasha analysis using Ashtak Varga, then please use it, see it, and over that you have to use transits, and you have to analyze the whole chart and see what's going on. Alright. Thank you so much. And if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Ashtak Varga, you can go to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Thank you so much.